This Al Jaffa Boxing Social in partnership with Empire Fight Store. It is a bit loud in there, I must admit. I'm joined by Dalton Smith, a man in demand, mate, here at Matchroom. Made the right decision?
Yeah, you know, definitely the right decision for my team, for me and my team. You know, and it's just nice to get straight back out, and no waiting about. And, you know, get straight back out and, you know, dancing again.
Great, though. Matchroom's first UK show of the year. What a show to be on, Dalton. You must admit that.
Yeah, you know, it's a phenomenal show. You know, look at the fight alone. It's going to be unbelievable. The main card alone is going to be unbelievable. So, you know, it's a great, great night to be a part of, as all the Matchroom cards are. You know, you're always getting quality. And yeah, it's going to be a big night.
I love the fact that you're defending that British title, I'll be honest with you. You want to win it outright. You love the history behind it, but there was a surprise with the opponent, but I guess he's English champion, so again, not a surprise. Just contradicting myself there.
Yeah, that's it. You know, Billy fought himself into a way to a position to fight for the British title. You know, so he was there for the challenge, and you know, he's come in with big intentions on Saturday night and one I can't overlook. So, you know, it's one I've got to be fully focused on.
Domestic fights, they always live up to expectations, I must admit. You know, your last one I saw you in, I do love a domestic dust-up, don't I? I'll be honest with you.
Of course, that's what brings the excitement. You know, two British fighters going head-to-head. You know, that's what the fans want to see, and also it's what gets us as fighters up for the challenge.
What have you seen in Billy that could pose a threat on Saturday? Don't give too much away, but what have you seen of him?
Yeah, you know, he's durable. He's never been stopped, never been dropped. And, you know, I've got to make sure I'm switched on Saturday. You know, I can't take my eye off the ball for no reason whatsoever. So, you know, all I do is I go in there, I'm always relaxed and do what Dalton Smith does and, you know, I get the job done.
Yeah, exactly. Obviously, you are here at Matchroom. This is a Matchroom show. Eddie Earn's over there doing interviews as well. How pleased are you, first of all, to be back, mate, really?
Oh, happy. You know, I've been here from the start. You know, I always feel welcome when I'm here with Eddie and the team. You know, it's a bit like a family affair, and you know, you feel loved here. You know, and you know, it's just nice. Well, as long as you feel comfortable, that's the main thing.
What was the discussion? It seemed many weeks ago that it seemed that Ben Shalom was pretty adamant that you were going to be signing with Boxer. I was pretty adamant that's the way you were going. So we saw you on Boxer. You know, obviously they're doing punditry, etc. How come you, well, changed your mind? Did you change your mind at all? I don't know how it sort of panned out, mate.
No, you know, I didn't make no decisions at all. You know, it was down to my team and then, you know, for me to make the final decision. But, you know, there's no bad blood there. You know, Sky looks after me and it's business at the end of the day. You know, I've got nothing but love for, you know, Sky Sports, for what they've done for me, even when I was with Eddie Earn and stuff. So, you know, at the end of the day, it's just business. You know, obviously the last fight was on Boxer with the purse bids and stuff, so that was out of my hands. You just got to do what you've got to do. But at the end of the day, it's business, and, you know, my team did the right decision.
You love the British title. You love to win it outright. Love the history behind it. How much is that of you as a person? Or I spoke to Junaid and Nico as well. Both want to do that traditional route as well. How much is it you, or is it Grant and the gym that's sort of, like, influencing those decisions?
No, it's me. You know, I only ever do what I want to do. You know, if it makes me happy, I don't listen to anybody else. You know, I'm young. Why would I not win a British title for keeps? You know, maybe I'd win a world title one day and probably regret never winning the British. Do you know what I mean? So it's, while I'm here, I'm going to do it.
You don't want to stay at British level for long. You want to move straight up. What does that mean?
You know what I mean? I've got to keep working hard. Every fight from here on now, he gets harder and harder. You know, we're in the fight game. It's not easy as it is. So, you know, I've just got to keep training hard, working hard, and you know, keep chasing greatness.
Is that how you simplify it? You know, don't put too much pressure on yourself in terms of looking at the bigger picture. You're boxing, it's a ring, it's the same thing every time you go in there. Is that how you sort of your mindset into this one? It's sort of simplifying it a little bit.
Yeah, you can't get too stuck in the mud with it all. Do you know what I mean? Like, too many people, like, they see the end goal and it's like, oh, I'm gonna enjoy the journey, man. Do you know what I mean? That's why I want to win the British title. You know, it's a journey, and I want to enjoy every single moment of it. You know, it's probably not going to be smooth all the way through. I'm probably going to have, you know, failures. I'm going to have dips. I'm going to have bumps in the road. But, you know what I mean? Let's enjoy it while we're here.
Your dad certainly doesn't make it easier for himself. I mean, again, three fighters on the card. He's going to be rushing around again on Saturday. seems to be consistent with Grant, doesn't it?
That's it, but when you're producing good fighters, they're going to be on big cards, so, you know, it's the recipe for his own success.
A fellow on the card as well, a fight that was so spoken about, was Sam Maxwell. Was that still a possible fight later down the road?
Yeah, you know, it's a possible fight there. You know, there's so many fights in my 140 division, but yeah, it's nice to see Sam getting back out on the undercard as well. And yeah, but I've just got one job to focus on, and that's Saturday night, and then, you know, I'll see what's there after that.
A little word on the two fellas in the Stay With Our Boxing and at the weekend, both Nico and Janae, both successful 2022s to say the least, Dalton.
Yeah, successful, and you know, they're both so talented. You know, Janaid is getting named the knockout artist now. Yeah, you know, laying people out. But do you know what? We used to give him stick in the gym because he used to say, I don't punch on if I can't punch. And he's knocking every. He's got the highest knockout ratio in the gym now. So, you know, it gives us lads some stick for it. But, you know, him and Nico and all the lads in the gym, you know, they're growing with strength to strength. And, you know, there's some talent coming out of the gym now. And, you know, expect some big performances on Saturday night.
What a headline on Saturday, though. It's not every day you see someone take a voluntary defence like Maurizio Lara, Dalton, is it?
That's it. It shows what type of fighter Lee is. You know, I've known Lee for many years now, and, you know, he says he's one of those, you know, he's dogged it out. I always remember when I was younger and he had an injury and whatnot, and his career got put, went stale a little bit. Had the defeat to McDonald. It just shows you dig it out, believe in yourself. How far you can get, and to pick no easy fights, you know, it shows what confidence he's got in himself, and you know, it's going to be one hell of a fight.
Any predictions you can give me for that one? I know you're going to back the Brit. Hopefully, I'm going to say you back the Brit.
Of course, you know, it's going to be a war, and I'm rooting for Lee. I want Lee to win 100%.
Quickly as well, before you leave, it is next week. I have to mention it. Jake Paul, Tommy Fury. Just a thought on that one, Dalton. I know you're smiling now.
You know. Do you know what? You've got to give it to him. It's entertaining, isn't it? But do you know what? I really think it's a 50-50 fight. It is a 50-50 fight. And, you know, I think Jake Paul's probably actually has grown on me over the years. And he has done some good things for boxing. And he's also bringing a lot of eyes to boxing. And you know what? He's not a bad fighter. But obviously it's hard to say because he's not being with a real fighter yet. So it is easy to say that. But, you know, he keeps proving everybody wrong. So...